We want monkeys! We want monkeys! Yay! Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's start the next game in the party games, Number Ball. And all you do is pretty much just point at a ball that's designated that you're supposed to click on and click on it with the A button. Basically, the normal version, this is one of the things that gives me the impression that they did not playtest a lot of these games, because if you get to 99 in the normal version, the whole Wii will actually freeze. So I'm gonna do the random version instead. In this one, you have to click on whatever number you're supposed to click on. Pay attention, like you see 19, just go to that one. 50, oh, well, not 15, 5, but yeah. you get the idea. It's a very, very, very simple game and quite boring, to be honest. But then again, a lot of them are, as you've noticed in the party games. I don't know why the playtesters didn't think you could get to 99 in that normal version or something, because it's pretty easy to do. You could probably even do it on your first try. But that's why I'm trying the random version of this here, because, well, I would prefer not to, you know, get to that point and then accidentally have to restart the Wii or my recording. And you'll also notice that the balls that you click on eventually get filtered off the screen to let in room for more balls. Dang it, I didn't mean to click on you. I wanted to click on that one. There we go. I still don't know how I said 15 instead of 5, or I don't know. Seriously, what has been wrong with me lately? So, yeah, this is pretty much Number Ball in a nutshell. I think the reason why the random one doesn't freeze is because they just, you know, give you random balls to choose from, but, you know, the normal one can only... Oh, 43, and I clicked 34. And the reason why is because there's only 99 balls, so what happens is that they don't have any more balls to throw out onto the field, and then, you know, that ends up freezing the system because, you know, it gives it a false sense of what it's supposed to do. It doesn't have the resources to do it. Something like that. So, yeah, I sort of understand why they didn't playtest a lot of these, because of the fact that, you know, there is a lot of games to playtest, but at the same time, you know, Nintendo was able to do that with Mario Party, and it's just like, they got all those games working pretty dang well, so why can't Sega do it with Banana Blitz here? And you'll notice that you get 1 point, oh, not 1 point, 100 points per ball. So in the normal mode, your highest score possible would be 9,800. Anyway, next game, that's all you're getting to see of that. We're going to Paper Sumo Fighter. I've apparently played this a bunch of times. What am I supposed to do? Move the cursor and hit the ground with the... Oh, I guess I'm supposed to vibrate ye ol' paper sumo wrestler over to knock the other one over or out of the ring. That's my guess here. it's another one of these... It's another one of these things where you gotta be... It's like working in a 3D space. Yeah, I've explained to you before why this is kind of awkward to do. But, well, this one's working pretty well, and I'm successfully pushing Paper Baby out of the ring here. Come on, Mimi, we can do this! Yeah! Move your paper bottom! Arrgh! Take Baby out! Arrgh! This is extreme gameplay right here! And that's pretty much it for the game. Just mash that A button like crazy! I guess that's pretty much it. Yeah, that one works pretty well, and I made that one a lot more exciting than it actually is. Next one. Oh. Is this the one that I'm thinking of? No, this isn't the one that I'm thinking of. There's a game that you fly and try to land on a target, but it is completely broken, and I'll be picking fun at that one to no end. But it's not this one. Okay, so you hold them upright. Mm-hmm. That's pretty simple. Just drop the hand that you want to use to turn, and to drop your speed, you drop both of them downwards. Oh my. A lot more modes here than I thought there would be. But I think I can do them all. Is this... Wait, maybe this is the one. Is this... No, this is... Yeah, this one does work, I think. It's just very subtle. No, wait, I'm still... No. The movement is so subtle, I can't tell. Come on, turn to your right. No, wait, this is the one that doesn't work. Because I am... See the wind at the bottom left corner there? I am... My right arm is dropped below the nunchuck. And... It seems to be refusing to turn. So how exactly am I supposed to get over to the target if I can't get it to move over there? You tell me how. So I guess this one is the unresponsive one that I was thinking of before. But I'm pretty sure I played the unresponsive game twice, at least twice before. Unless there's another version of this game that plays just as crappy. So... There we go, I suppose. That's... If the game is broke, the game is broke. Racing Birds is next, I guess. Is this another hold in front of your face at a 90 degree angle thing? Oh, I see. Flap your wings or flap your arms to go up. And then left and right is just to tilt both hands at the same time. That's pretty simple. Alright! Let's do this! That wasn't very graceful. I am ready! Yeah, this controls pretty well. Alright, I think I can do this. Come on, little birdie, let's fly through the wings! Hopefully more gracefully than Mimi was in that little opening cutscene sequence there. Go up, please! I don't want to miss any ring! I can't miss the rings, for I must get the high score! Yeah, apparently I played this, and I managed to get a high score there. I mean, I highly doubt that would be the default high score there. Because, you know, it's usually an even number of sorts, like 2,000 or something like that, not the 13,870. And this is a very, very, very easy and linear game, I have to say. I suppose if you hit some things, that could be catastrophe, but I don't see that happening very often. It's very easy to navigate around here. Just flick both Wii remotes when you want to go up or alternate them, whatever you feel like doing. And this is, yeah, I guess this one's a lot more fun than, you know, a game that doesn't control properly at all. Come on, that's just embarrassing. We're talking about a supposed professional game here. Ooh, the rings are getting a lot smaller. Oh man, I hope I'll be able to get through them. Yeah, now that I got the hang of the controls, it's pretty easy to get through them. Although these ones are a little bit tighter spaced. Oh, I missed one! No! Oh, there's a time limit, so that's what restricts you from getting a higher score. Because I was going to say, is there any proverbial end to this, other than that map down there? Oh, shoot, I didn't see that one up there! No! I bet you this course is probably the same, no matter how many times you play it. It's just a guess. As I said, I'm only going to play each of these once. And through the colored pearly gates for the goal. But how do you get the high score? Do you get bonus points for like getting a certain amount of them in a row? Oh, a time bonus as well as the rings. I see. That makes me wonder if like it would be better to just avoid most of the rings that, you know, would take you out of the way to... aim for a better time bonus, because the time bonus was pretty substantial. Anyway, next game! We're getting through these fast now. Red light, green lights! So you just simply waggle to move forward and stop by stopping all those waggles. And you should probably know how to play red light, green light if you've ever been a kid. You just go when they're not looking and stop when they're going to be looking. You'll notice that little meter at the top of the screen there indicates when they're going to look. Well, oh shoot, I didn't mean to twitch. I didn't get very far anyway. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Now stop, 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 stop. I do not want to get caught. Oh no, gone, gone. No, he made it. No. And that's pretty much it for red light, green light. Oh, I guess it's a best of so many rounds. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Oh shoot, why do I keep twitching? Maybe I should just like put the Wii remotes down or something like that when they're going to be looking. Okay, dropping them, dropping them. No, I lost the gong gong again. The same gong gong. Yeah, there's no duplicate gong gongs here. But there are in some other games, like in Monkey Racing when they have to duplicate characters to fill in extra spaces. Huh? What? I swear I did not touch anything that time. I put them on the ground. Maybe they rolled over or something like that. Go, 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 I am ready to waggle! Drop it! I wonder if she just sometimes, like, does that little twitchy thing, like, at random, just to throw you off? I don't know. Go, 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 go! What? No! I was so close to getting another point! But you get the idea of red light, green light. Again, I'm making this game a lot more exciting than it actually is. Ring toss! Uh-oh. Something tells me this isn't going to work well based on how many times I've played this game. Alright, so I flick rings at little posts. Oh no, not the arrow cursor again! No, it's monkey golf! Well, disc golf. All over again! What? How dare you do this to me twice? Nah, it does seem to be working, you know, when the arrow was actually on the screen. That one I overthrew. Okay, okay. I will get this. I will get this. Yeah, this one does seem to work better, so I can live with this. It does seem to be responsive to the, to how hard I throw it, so it's not like monkey bowling where it seemed to randomly detect how much spin it wanted and not how much spin I was actually inflicting on the ball. Yeah! Getting the hang of this. Okay, I'm gonna aim for that back left one now. I'm gonna call my shots here. No, not that one. What are those rings that appear around the post? Are they like to make it harder to get the ring to stay around the post or something like that? I don't know if that would really do much of a job. I mean, that would be a... the ring has to go over them, so it's not like those metal rings around the base could possibly prevent the ring from flopping over them, unless it makes the tip of the post larger, which makes it harder for the ring to get across, like if I were to get three rings in a row or something like that. Well, that's ring toss. Game over. I wonder if you could aim for the same posts multiple times in a row or something like that. I don't know. Anyway, next game is rock, paper, scissors attack. What? What? I've never played this before, and it's rock, paper, scissors. This is the game of all games. This is the game manly men play. And I just had to connect my nunchuck to it there. Okay, so how do you do the gestures? A and B for rock, B for scissors, and what? to hit with the hammer. What kind of rock, paper, scissors game is this? Is this... Am I supposed to, like, guard from... Okay, so scissors is A or B, just on their own, and rock is A and B, and nothing is... Yeah, okay. I have a feeling that I'm going to be needing to know how to guard against something. So I best memorize page 3 here. So I guess when I have a win, I hit with the hammer, and when I don't, I guard with the helmet. Oh my, this is not going to go well. Ready? Oh, I did the wrong hand. I must not confuse my guard hand. And I've got my hands confused again. This could actually be fun because of the way that that you have to react to everything. Hey, what the heck happened there? I didn't do any sort of gesture. Did you see that? Hit up. Aww, I had that one. I guess the helmet is to. Again, there wasn't any reaction from me. I was holding the B button and twitching, well, whatever. But yeah, I think this one could be fun because of the way that you would have to, like, learn how to automatically react to their losses or your losses, you know, to guard yourself. That takes sort of the luck factor of rock, paper, scissors away, actually, and puts more of an emphasis on reaction time and skill. Let's scoop some goldfish. Let's scoop the goldfish. This sounds exciting. I do like fish, but scooping goldfish may be a little cool. Okay, so I bet you it's another one of those things where I have to it's based on my position on the screen. Or maybe I just point at the screen. No. Oh, it is based in a 3D space again. Curses! Tilt, lift up, lack more. No, I want to lift up. Wait, my net is... Oh, you have to press the A button to replenish it. Okay. Pick up fishy. Yes, 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 yes. Yeah, alright. But this is very, very twitchy. And why am I using a flat net of all things? Why is it not... Oh, my net broke again. And, oh, you gotta be really gentle when you lay your net in the water. This is like toilet paper net. It's biodegradable. Why would anyone use a net like this? It is too fragile. Okay, I'm gonna replenish my net there. Come on, Blackmore. No, I must get different kind of goldfish before clock runs out. No, this is actually pretty hard. And this is very twitchy, may I add. I wonder if that has to do with, like... I wonder if that would actually hurt you in the long run, like if you were to splash your net into the water or something like that. You know what? I'm going to try that one more time against my better judgment here. Just because it's fish, and that game doesn't take very long at all. I mean, it's only a minute. Alright, fish! I'm gonna get... I did not mean to do that. I'm going to get this koi. No! Don't swim out of my net! And into the bucket. Okay. And I'll grab this normal goldfish if I can get the perspective right. I can't get the perspective right, apparently. I'm going to splash and get rid of my net there. I should say my tissue. Bathroom tissue. Nets. Yeah, why would you use this sort of thing to try and catch fish of all things? It should be a net that's more like cup shape, so the fish can't flop themselves off the platform of sorts. No, don't like what they're doing right now. Curses. No, my net broke. Get Blackmore. Yay, bubble eye fishy. Nice. I got another one. My net broke. No. Get another one! Aww! Looks like if you move too fast, the fish fall off your net as well. And I use the term net very loosely here. If I was a fish, I could easily flop myself off of that toilet paper tissue thing every single time just by flicking my tail. Alright, so apparently I'm supposed to... Oh, is this one of those things that I have to, like, balance a ball? Yeah, okay. Or at least I have to get a ball somewhere. Oh, there's multiple courses. Okay, let's start with one. Of course. Ah, I see, you have to get over to the target. So I just tilt left and right to control where it's going. So I'm just gonna... Whoa! Why is that so haphazard? Can I restart? Oh, okay, I can. Whoa, why is this so super sensitive? Eh. It's like they twitch all the way to from, like, nothing to max if you have it, like, past a certain point. Come on, just gently get yourself over there. And I see the bananas give you points. That's in part of the game. Oh! Otherwise, this one does seem to work fairly well, other than it being twitchy at first. We got ourselves a moving platform here, which also moves on its own. No, it doesn't really move on its own. It reacts to the, you know, where the ball is nearest to it. Whoa! So is the objective to get as close to the center as possible? Oh, it's both. Oh, it's actually three things. Getting bananas, the time, as well as the target landing. Okay. And that determines your points. It's pretty simple. And let's just put in my name. There we go. Lots of effort put into that. And let's do the next course, which I'm inevitably going to fall out a bunch of times again. Yes. And... course two. By the way, I gotta say, these party games are taking me longer to complete than the actual main game. Doesn't that seem a little bit odd? Whoa, these are bouncy. Really bouncy. Or maybe I'm using them as like flippers or something like that if I flick my arm. No, wait, maybe these orange ones are a little bit more bouncy. Eh, no, don't go that far. No, I don't want to. No, go. No, I wasn't tilting that way. You've seen that. You've seen where I was tilting last. And somehow I managed to keep it under control. I am astonished. What is this purple one? That purple one... Oh. You can't control the purple ones. I see. Alright. Target, target, target. Yay! I did a lot better. This game isn't too shabby. It's not too linear. It's got collectibles. It makes you think about where you want to take your route through it, and then, you know, you have to skillfully do it. You have to skillfully get through the course. So, Justin approves of this game, or excuse me, Jay, or excuse me, PkGam. Wait, one more course. So what am I going over to the sheep for? Number three, hard course! Set the ball of lava! This is going to be fun, I think. Are those moving platforms? Like those orange ones? Whoa! Oh, I see the orange ones are all synced together. That's the gimmick of that color. Oh, okay, I got it now. I understand this madness. And then you flick the character to get onto the... Yeah, like that. Alright, I've got this down, I think. Woo! I'm losing control! Okay. Get the bananas, the king of fruit for monkeys. Get me over to green platform number two. That was another two, but a different kind of two. Get over two bananas. I don't know if I should be working on time or if I should be working on, you know, you get the idea, like landing on the target or the time or bananas. I don't know which one is the most efficient to get the most points. I'd have to play it a bunch of times to get the hang of it. And I just realized this part has gone on for quite a while. So I think I'm going to end it off here and leave whatever that sheep game was for the next part. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you then.